What is up, boys and girls? My name is V, and welcome back to What Remains of Edith Finch. So in the previous episode, things got really trippy. I was a cat, I was a shark, and I ate rabbits. And this episode, we're gonna move on. This game is really cool. I'm a big fan of it, and I think it's only gonna get trippier. Okay, so now we found out what happened
this
to Molly.
This will be obvious later, but my mom never told me any of these stories. Edie would have, but Mom didn't like bringing up the past. Though, when we adopted a stray kitten, she was the one who named it Molly.
So they named the kitten Molly. The mom knew about Molly. That Molly had turned into a cat. So wait, did Molly really turn into a cat? That's freaky.
I spent a lot of time in Great Grandma Edie's room.
Oh. What's that noise?
What's that? When Edie told people Sven was killed by a dragon, she could also have said he was building a dragon-shaped slide that collapsed. She could have, but she didn't.
I like that. She could have, but she didn't. I like that a lot. Oh, okay. Built 1937. Sven Finch. Edie won't go. 72-year-old woman refuses to evacuate because of a little forest fire.
One summer, they evacuated the island, but Edie refused to go. For a few weeks, she was a celebrity.
Cool. Molly concepts. Can I touch that? Can't. Oh. Mysteries of death and thereafter. Wow. So.
I hadn't thought of myself as Edith Jr. for a long, long time. Edie gave a big interview about a mole man living under the Finch house. My mom was furious.
Okay, so the mom was trying to protect the daughter from all these secrets, I guess. Okay, so there, this house, there's a lot of secrets.
Oh. Lewis died a week before we left, but Edie had already started to memorialize him.
How did
Edie knit me a new pair of gloves every year, just in time to replace the old ones.
So I'm using the old gloves, I guess. Lewis.
Her room was like a museum.
Okay, so that's okay. Anything else we can read before Sven, Edie? Anything else we can do before we go into this story? Open this door.
Even in her 90s, sometimes Edie seemed a lot younger than my mother.
Oh. Wow.
The only trace Grandpa Sam's first wife Kay left on the house was the pink bathroom.
Pills. I'm recording audio, right?
It was okay. A pretty big trace.
Tell me about it. So pink. So wow. Okay, so that's another door. We're not gonna go in there yet. Okay. Hey! Okay. Let's just open up this. Let's read this story first and then we'll move on to the next one, okay? Okay.
For 500 years, the Finches have been famous throughout Norway for their fortune and misfortune.
Ooh, Norway. So are we in Norway? I thought we're in America. Okay. Hold on. What next? What? Oh, do I scroll with the mouse wheel?
A Odin Finch buries the latest victims of the family curse. His wife, Ingeborg, and their newborn son, Johan.
Oh, Odin Finch. What curse?
On January 7th, 1937, he set sail with his family and his house, hoping to leave the curse behind.
So they brought the house from Norway to Washington. And they brought the house to Washington, I guess the curse followed them, but what curse?
But 40-foot waves off the coast of Washington send the house and Odin to the bottom of the sea.
Oh dear.
Odin's daughter Edie, with husband Sven and baby Molly, step ashore on their new home, Orcas Island.
Oh, okay, so that's... Okay, so that's Grandma Edie and Sven, when they built the house in 1937. And Molly, okay.
Odin Finch is the first to be buried in the new family cemetery.
Oh, so that's the guy we saw on the... That's the house.
His daughter Edie is already dreaming of a new Finch house.
Oh, they look so nice. What? Okay, so I guess that's it. Okay. Oh, okay. Okay.
Whatever's wrong with this family, it goes back a long ways.
Okay, so now we know what happened. Okay, great. Okay. Moving this around is quite Odin Finch. Cool, okay. Bathroom time. Can I open that? Nope. Can I open any of this? Nope. Okay, the next room. There's a secret in this bathroom by Sven and Edie Finch. Oh, cool.
There's a secret in this bathroom. It's in the last place you would look. It isn't in the cupboard. It's hidden in this book.
Whoa. 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 Hey, it's a dark room. It's a dark room!
Sven gave Sam an old camera he'd refurbished. He never put it down.
So this is... Sam, whoever Sam is, that's his dark room. This is his dark room, man. Okay. In here. That's Sam, I guess. Bathroom selfie. Kelvin Finch. I can touch, right? Okay. Milton. So Milton was here as well. Whoa. Odin Finch National Park. Cool. This was the brother that shared a room with his dead brother, right?
I knew Grandpa Sam had a twin. And that he never talked about him.
Okay. Okay. Nope. I want to go out here first. Okay.
I guess my grandpa didn't like history any more than my mom did.
Calvin.
How I Want to Remember My Brother by Sam Finch. The thing I remember is that when he made up his mind, that was it. My brother said he'd die before he ate another mushroom, and he did. At Barbara's funeral, we swore we'd never be afraid again, and he wasn't. I think Calvin always wanted to fly.
I am swinging.
No!
But that day, he finally made up his mind to do it.
Let's fly.
I told him going around was impossible. Maybe if I hadn't said that.
Calvin, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Maybe if the wind hadn't picked up. Then maybe he'd still be here. But I doubt it. I think he'd already made up his mind. That's what I want to remember about my brother.
Whoa.
He made up his mind to fly. And he did.
Calvin's story felt strangely familiar. When I was younger, I remember trying to do the exact same thing.
Okay. So, that's what happened to Calvin. He flew.
After the funeral, Edie roped off Calvin's half of the room.
Oh. Camera. That's a lot of film.
Mom said Grandpa Sam enlisted at 18 and never set foot in the room again.
Cool. Anything else here? Okay, I guess that's it. Okay. So now we know what happened to Calvin Finch. Okay, let's go.
Passages were a pretty tight fit. They'd obviously been built for smaller hands and bellies.
Whoa. Okay, let's just check here. Oh!
Edie's father, Odin, built the original house.
So I guess we're gonna go into Barbara's room after this. Oh, that's cool. Okay. Is this still locked? Yep, still locked. Okay. Okay. Let's go. Barbara
Growing up,
Finch.
I always thought of Barbara as a child star.
That's scary. No, I don't want to go inside. No, I don't want to go inside. I don't want to go inside. I want to let me out. Okay.
I never thought about how hard it must have been for her afterwards.
Oh, it's cake. Barbara. Can I click on anything, or am I just gonna... Oh, that's quite sad. Okay, let's find out how she died.
Of all the stories people wrote about Barbara's death, I'm surprised Edie saved this one.
Oh, that's why we saw the...
Old Jack here with another ghastly tale inspired by America's most unfortunate family. I'm calling it... The surprise ending of Barbara Finch. As a child star, Barbara was famous for her scream.
Okay.
Now at 16, she was all washed up. A has-been. But in a lucky break, she'd been asked to perform her signature scream at a local convention for monster movie fans. It was just the boost her career needed. Unfortunately, her scream hadn't aged well.
Getting better? I think you just need the right motivation.
Her biggest fan and current boyfriend, Rick, was about to demonstrate when...
Now that was a great scream.
It was Barbara's father, Sven. He'd slipped into a table saw and had to be rushed to the emergency room. So Barbara got stuck babysitting her youngest brother, Walter. Her convention comeback was canceled.
Okay, I'm hearing frustration, but I'm not hearing terror. What if I tried...
A gang of hoodlums in Halloween masks have been terrorizing Orca's Island tonight. Police are urging residents to...
That came from the basement.
You're right. Also, I loved your delivery on that. Why is your basement door locked?
Because my dad likes making puzzles and secret passages. There's a key hidden in the music box. The secret is to keep winding and winding until finally the key pops out.
Thanks, babe. I'll be back in a sec.
20 minutes later... Rick hadn't returned.
Oh, dear.
So Barbara went to look for him, right on cue. She reached for the music box.
Oh, what? Oh. Can I... What? Oh.
And as she wound the key, she listened for Rick, but the house was silent.
Okay, don't go in. Don't go in. Oh dear.
She found Rick's crutch and imagined the worst.
Oh dear, is that blood? Oh god. Oh dear. Or is that the father's blood? I don't know.
The gang's leader is the infamous Hookman killer, Dr. Carl Hamill, who impaled and then ate his family 10 years ago tonight.
scary. Oh dear.
The old fridge rattled and grew still.
Relax. I was just trying to scare you to help you find your scream.
Well, I'm not scared, Rick. I'm furious.
Oh.
Then act furious. All I'm getting from you now is that you're hurt and confused and...
She threw him out, but she kept a little something to remember him by.
Barb, have you seen my other crutch?
And she was still holding it when she fell asleep. Watching the late, late picture show. Hours later...
Barbara! Walter, what's going on up there? Ah! Okay, I'm coming up. But if this is a trick, you're dead, Walter.
She shouldn't have said I'm dead, because she might be dead. Oh, shit. Here, okay.
Walter had vanished, but his bedside radio was still on.
Orcas Island police described the man as 6 feet tall, with a steel hook for a hand. Residents are urged to lock all doors and windows and notify the police of any suspicious activity.
Oh dear.
Barbara turned, saw the hook man, and was speechless. He was quite smashing. And he was. He couldn't get enough of Barbara.
Okay, Barbara. There's got to be another way out of here.
Okay, in here. Get in here.
That night, she played her part beautifully. Moving, but she sensed the story might not be over yet.
You know, if I were her, I would just run out the front door now. Like, why would you try to attack this guy? Seriously. Oh.
The hook man had vanished. She listened for his breathing. But all she heard was... Someone at the door was dying to speak to young Barbara. At the door, she heard whispering. It was coming from inside the house.
Oh dear.
Surprise!
Bravo, Barbara!
You were wonderful!
The monsters had come to surprise her. For Barbara, it was a dream come true. Then she saw what kind of monsters they were, and she realized what was about to happen.
What?
She was going to be famous. And with her final breath, Barbara Finch gave the performance of her life. I wasn't there myself, but I hear Barbara was magnificent.
What?
Poor girl. She had a taste for stardom. But unfortunately, so did her fans. Of course, the police blamed it all on poor Rick, who disappeared the same night. And little Walter? Hiding under his bed the whole time. He took it all pretty hard. But that's another story. As for Barbara, tucked inside the music box is all they ever found of her. Her ear.
Oh. Ew.
Now that's what I call
God.
A real eerie tale.
No shit! Okay. The ear at the back. Why?
Edie told me all Barbara wanted was to be remembered, as absurd as that comic was. Maybe what Edie saw was a happy ending.
Okay. Okay. Okay, guys. So that happened. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna end this episode here. We just witnessed how Barbara died. So yeah, part two of What Remains of Edith Finch. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you like the video, give it a like. If you want to see more from me, hit that subscribe button and the bell notification, because I upload 5 times a week every day except for Sunday and Monday. Can't wait to see you guys in the next video. Also, I stream on twitch.tv/playedbyv Tuesdays, Thursdays, Saturdays, sometimes more. Schedule will be on the Twitch page or on my About section on my YouTube page. Thanks for watching. But yeah, that's it. And I will see you guys in the next video. But till then, I've been V. You've been you. Until the next time, y'all stay safe, stay calm, stay happy, be yourself, be happy, and be epic. I'll see you guys in the next episode.